We are here picking up Todd to go on our adventure, and there's Todd right there, and there's Stefan. But this sign, the way it's scrunched up, it makes it look like it says no renting, and that's not good for business. We're out here about to try to fit 5 people into this Ford Fiesta.
Too close!
Okay.
I'm not even in the middle!
Okay, the Todd is in.
I must say, I don't think I'd recommend 5 people in the Fiesta.
Does it feel okay for you?
Right now it does, but...
Ask her in 5 hours. Okay. Here's the problem. The door isn't designed, and the seat isn't designed for me to move over to make room for her. It pushes me in towards the center.
What is it, like spring-loaded? Would you rather fit 5 people into the Fiesta or get waterboarded?
Nah, I'd rather fit 5 people.
Oh, see? That's why you should buy a Ford Fiesta.
It's better than getting waterboarded.
Stefan's joke of the day.
What do you get when you give an upcoming Ford vehicle to the world's best YouTuber? A Michael Fiesta Ronda.
Stefan's joke of the day.
Okay, we're all ready to go on our trip. We're about to leave, and then the car just informed me that the boot is open. So,
Todd?
Todd, would you be a dear and, would you like to close my boot?
Gladly.
As one of 100 agents granted the use of a 2011 Ford Fiesta for 6 months, I have been assigned secret missions to put the vehicle to the test. This month, we're cramming 5 people into the car and road tripping to Yosemite National Park. Our mission is to conquer Yosemite Falls, the tallest waterfall in North America, at nearly 2,500 feet. But of course, we began our journey with a car wash to ensure that the car looked fabulous to those who would see us on the road. We stopped for food in Bakersfield and did our daily workouts to ensure our muscles wouldn't atrophy due to the lack of gravity in the Fiesta. We stopped to sleep at a Motel 6 and awoke early the next morning for breakfast at the local Denny's.
There's just so much to eat here, I don't even know what to choose.
I like the aesthetic qualities of their menus. I feel like they're a bit more artistic than has been the case in the past. Yes?
Hmm?
Yeah.
Minimalism.
Yeah. Do you guys happen to have some kind of printout with the caloric values daily, like...
Say it again?
The nutritional information.
Yeah, the nutritional information.
Oh, I think she has allergies. I don't know if she has...
Psst. I've just been informed that they don't have nutritional information available. As far as I understand, that's illegal. So if you're a health official, you should come down to the Denny's in Madera, California, right next to the Motel 6. Tell them Michael LaRonda sent ya.
Once our food arrived, we took our time to enjoy both the very delicious, very healthy food and each other's company in the midst of the quiet and pleasant restaurant atmosphere.
This is the real Denny's experience.
And now it's time for another episode of The Whiny Canadian. With the wine cone.
So a lot of people, actually not a single person asked, I'm saying that for dramatic effect, have been wondering why I didn't take part of this Ford Fiesta movement contest thingy. The reason why I didn't enter the Ford Fiesta movement contest thingy is because the rules stated that it was only open for the Americans of the United States of America. What about the Canadians of Canada? I certainly don't know. Does Ford think that Canada doesn't have any cars? Is that what it is? Ford, you do realize that many years ago, we actually progressed from snow dogs and sleds, okay, mush, to automobiles, you know, honk, honk, drive. So basically, what I'm saying is that I actually don't know what I'm saying, except that I wanted a Ford Fiesta, but you guys at Ford thought the Canadians don't even own cars, so we weren't even worthy enough to enter this contest. I don't even own a snow dog. I don't even own a dog. I don't even own a sled.
Tallest waterfall in America. But for an extra challenge, we're taking this along. Feel that. Okay. We're estimating that this is a good 20 pounds on my back. It's going all the way up there.
More than that, man. That's like 40.
We're ready to go up there to the top of the waterfall. We just better lock the door to make sure nobody steals anything. Door is locked, guys. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
Yeah.
Are you ready?
Let's just go.
Let's go. Let's do this. Guys, this backpack's kind of heavy. Does anyone want to carry it for me?
That way.
Maybe. I don't want to carry this anymore, guys.
Forgot that you have to pay to use payphones.
Okay, so Todd is very pale, and he must put on sunscreen to protect himself from the sun.
You ready?
Yep.
Every time you go on a long hike or a long journey, you always have to have some sort of treat at the end. And I have with me my victory lollipop, which will be eaten at the top.
The land of the free and the home of the brave. It's freedom, everybody.
I'm Andrea.
How's it going, Todd?
I give up. I think we've been on it for 10 minutes and I'm done. It's really fun.
I don't know how far up we are. I assume we've got a ways to go still. But we lost the Todd. He decided that his energy would be better spent reading a book. So he's down at the bottom, delving into a world of fantasy while we continue on. Oh, jeez. Between managing my physical exertion levels and my water levels and managing the camera and trying to post to Twitter, I can feel the strain, the mental strain.
It's like a Bob Ross painting.
Where's the happy trees? I'm gonna show you guys, you know, if you're out in the wilderness and you need to forage for food, because I'm really hungry right now, I'll show you something that not many people know. If you find a cave like this, you can come in and you just check these cracks, because sometimes zone bars grow in caves like this. Well, we made it to Upper Falls. As you can see, this is the tallest waterfall in America, right here. It was an arduous journey, but I'm glad that we made the effort. Time to go home. Thank you. Jessica, how do you feel about it?
I think it's absolutely beautiful.
Most of this trail is a bunch of stones that have been laid down in sort of a stairwell fashion. But it's, I can't imagine the number of man hours required to put this whole thing together. I mean, this whole thing is almost 4 miles long. So much water. It feels like it's raining. I really hope that we don't get attacked by any bears right now, because I'm so tired that I just might let him eat me. They need to install an escalator that comes up here.
After 3.5 hours of some of the most strenuous hiking I've ever done, we reached the top. And it was worth every second.
So, I think it's time I got my victory pop here. Although I didn't actually complete the journey to the waterfall thing. Around Vision.